Minneapolis City Council today approved $16 million in affordable housing grants, which will help build projects across the city. As John Croman reports, it's part of a larger effort to end homelessness.
The vacant lot along Nicollet Avenue, where the Wells Fargo Bank sat before it was trashed by rioters, will soon be home to 110 families and a bank branch. Project for Pride and Living is getting part of the money from the Minneapolis Affordable Housing Trust Fund.
This is a site from our perspective that demanded that the community have agency and voice.
The City Council agreed to spend $16 million on grants to 10 projects, including Emerson Village, a complex being built by Beacon Interfaith Housing in North Minneapolis.
Emerson Village is an investment in racial equity to disrupt these systems. An eviction on your record will not be a barrier to calling Emerson Village a home.
In St. Paul, a celebration of the Parkway, a new affordable housing complex private developer Jay Couvain built with help from the city and corporate foundations.
33 units are three bedrooms, 18 units are two bedrooms, the rest being one bedroom.
The Parkway includes amenities like a fitness room, the heated underground parking.
That's the stuff in which we're trying to bring to the community, that just because it's affordable doesn't mean it can't have all the amenities.
There's growing recognition that money spent on affordable housing is smart money. Stable housing helps kids do better in school, makes it easier for people to find and keep jobs, and also helps reduce folks' interaction with the criminal justice system. For KARE 11 News, I'm John Croman.
In addition to the financial investment, the cities of Minneapolis and St. Paul are also working with nonprofits and developers to help them navigate city rules and regulations on construction.